Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Hope all of you are fine and doing well at your home. Today, I am here to teach you a chapter of moral studies that you know as MST. The name of the chapter is The Mosque. The mosque, we commonly know that the mosque. What is mosque actually? In our locality, or normally we say masjid. Masjid in English, the word mosque is used for masjid. Masjid, what is masjid? Masjid is the place for sajda. Masjid is the place for worshipping Allah. So we are going to read in this chapter about the mosque. Not only about a particular mosque, we are reading about mosque as common noun, commonly about all mosque. First of all, I'd like to read the whole chapter, and I want all of you to open your book and go through the chapter again with me once, and after completion of my discussion, once again you will go through the chapter, and whatever I will say, you will understand it better if you go through the chapter again after the completion of the class. So here it is. There is a mosque in Medina. It is called the Prophet's Mosque. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself had it built. Medina is in Saudi Arabia. The building of this mosque was very simple. The walls were of brick and earth. The roof was of palm leaves. Our Prophet took part in building this mosque. The mosque is now a very beautiful building. There are mosques all over the world. A mosque is a place where the Muslim pray. Masjid is the Arabic word for mosque. Most mosques have all tall towers. These towers are called minarets. In some mosques, the azan, call to prayer, goes out from minarets. Mosques are holy places. It is very important to keep them clean. No one may enter a mosque in shoes. Every mosque has a big prayer hall. Every prayer hall has a niche. This is called the mihrab. The mihrab shows where the Kaaba is. Kaaba is the oldest house of prayer in Mecca. It is the most sacred place for prayer. Muslims do not worship the Kaaba, they worship Allah alone. Because it is holy, all the Muslims turn towards the Kaaba when they offer salah. The direction of the Kaaba in Mecca is clearly shown in every mosque by the mihrab. So this is the chapter I read. Now I'm going in detail. In Medina, there is a mosque. We know, we all Muslims, we commonly know two places very well, Mecca and Medina. They are the sacred places for us. They are the holy places for us. Mecca, where Kaaba is, and Medina. Medina is also famous for one mosque. Name of the mosque is Masjid-e-Nabawi. In English, we say this one, Prophet's Mosque. Masjid-e-Nabawi means Prophet's Mosque. So whoever goes to Hajj, they visit this Masjid-e-Nabawi also. Some of the works of Hajj are there in Mecca, and some they have to perform in Medina. So very sacred mosque this one is. Why it is sacred? Because this was our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's mosque. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had it built. That means Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had built it. That's why the name of the mosque is Prophet's Mosque. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we know he is the last prophet of Allah, and we are his ummats. We are his followers. So he was the most loved of all the prophets. He was the number one loved one of Allah. Allah had sent a lot of messengers, uncountable. Some say that 1,24,000. It is that actually innumerable. Out of all the prophets, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the most loved one of Allah subhanahu ta'ala. And he himself built this mosque, built this masjid. That's why we call that mosque as Prophet's Mosque or Masjid-e-Nabawi. Where is Medina? We got the place of Prophet's Mosque. It is in Medina. Now we have to understand where is Medina. Medina is in Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is a country. We are living in our country. Name of our country is what? India. Like this, many countries are there in the world. Approximately 209 countries are there. And Saudi Arabia is one of those countries. And Medina is a city. Medina is a famous city of Saudi Arabia. The building of this mosque was very simple. When it was first built, we can simply imagine. Presently we have bricks, presently we have cements and so many things, tiles, etc. What we use we use in our mosques, in our houses also. But at that time, when this first mosque in Medina built by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was built, at that time there was no brick, there was no cement. So the building or the shape of the mosque was very simple. The walls were of brick and earth. The walls of this mosque was made up of brick and earth. See, brick of our time and brick of that time was different. They are not same. Brick of that time, it was not burnt well. Simply from earth, it was given the shape of brick, not like the shape of our time's brick. So very simply it was constructed. The walls were constructed. And the roof of the mosque was of palm leaves. So we need a roof for every house, for every mosque also we need a roof. So Prophet's mosque also needed one roof. The roof was made, why? To protect the person who are there in the mosque from sunshine and from rainwater. So this we give roof, why? To protect ourselves from sunshine and from rainwater. Like this, that time also, this to protect the persons who were there in the mosque from sunshine and rain water, roof has been given. So one thing more here we have to know, that means a little amount of rain takes place in Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is commonly known as the land of deserts. So it is full of deserts. Rain water, that means rainfall, amount of rainfall is very low. Sometimes it takes place heavily, but generally amount of rainfall in Saudi Arabia totally, not only in Medina, total in whole Saudi Arabia, the amount of rainfall is very low. So roof was made of what? Palm trees, palm leaves. Palm, do you understand? It's a fruit we take in our area also, it is there. So this is a very hard fruit. We have to cut it, then we have to make it soft, then only we can take. And you guys know, you are very small, you don't try this one, very hard it is, you cannot take. If you start chewing, no, your teeth may break. So palms are there, but you guys, I am advising you, you don't take it, it is very hard. When you will become a bit bigger, no, then only you can take it. So you can commonly, that means simply understand, it's a strong fruit. The trees are like the coconut trees, very long. Coconut trees are not that long, but palm trees are very long, and their leaves are widespread. So using these leaves, the roof of the Prophet's mosque was built. Why? Because tin was not there at time, and this idea of giving shilling using rod, using cement, using this sand and bricks, this idea was not there. That's why the roof was built with the help of palm leaves. very very important thing. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most loved one of our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is the most respected of all the prophets. And when the mosque was built, at that time also he was the most respected among all the people of Medina. Not only Medina, among all the people of Makkah and Medina, but he himself took part in building this mosque. What happens when we make something? So if I am a respected one, I am a respectable one, we take ourselves away from doing work. The inferiors, the younger ones, they make this one. But our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not like that. He used to consider himself common man like everyone. So it's a great lesson from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we are to consider ourselves common. If we become the president, even president of India or the MLA or any minister, then also we are to consider ourselves common. This message has been given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by taking part in building the mosque. First of all, we are human being, then we are something else. So as human being, we all are same. So this message has been delivered by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by taking part in building Prophet's mosque. Now presently, if someone goes to Medina and visit Prophet's mosque, he or she will find it very beautiful. Very beautiful decoration is very nice, world class decoration, design very nice, world class design. This kind of designs we may not find in any other mosques. What is there in Prophet's mosque, that is Masjid-e-Nabawi. Why? Time has passed, people had gathered knowledge how to design, how to decorate places. So this design and decoration came in the minds of the people of Medina also, and they had changed the old structure of Masjid-e-Nabawi, and now they had built a very nice mosque, a very beautiful one. There are mosques all over the world. Only Masjid-e-Nabawi is not only the mosque in whole world. Every nook and corner of the world, wherever Muslims are there, we will find what? Mosques. Mosques are there. Without mosques, we cannot perform our salats. We cannot perform our namaz. See, simply it is said that it is extra thing I am telling you. The male people who we are, not female, not ladies, okay? Male people, namaz should be performed in mosque. Without mosques, the namaz will not be accepted by Allah, except in some cases, if it is too hot, if it is rainy season, someone cannot go to mosque, then it is exceptional, we can perform mosque in our homes. Like during this lockdown period, presently also mosques are closed, it is prohibited to go to mosque. That's why it is allowed, Allah will accept our prayer, Allah will accept our namaz from our home. Generally, male people should go to mosques to perform their namaz. Why? Because this is the most sacred place for all the Muslims. Normally what we say, your parents normally tell you that mosque is the house of Allah. Yes, it is, mosque is the house of Allah, where we can talk to mosque, talk to Allah. If we go to mosques, then we are performing namaz, means what? We are talking to Allah. So directly, whenever we perform namaz in mosques, it means what? In his house, we are talking to him. In his house means what? In Allah's house, we are talking to Allah. That's why this is the most sacred place for Muslims. And earlier I told you, Masjid is the Arabic word for mosque. Like we have books, we consider this one, this is your MST book, like this in Arabic, this is the Arabic word for book is what? Kitab. So similarly, we are reading about mosque, the Arabic word of mosque is what? Masjid. Masjid came from what? Sajda. That means the place where we give sajda, this is called masjid. Most of the mosques in India Or most of the mosques in our locality also, we'll find what? They have tall towers. Towers, they are known as what? Minarets. Okay? In earlier times, people used to give azan from these tall towers, from these minarets. Presently, we have loudspeaker, we have mic, etc. So, we are not in need of going to the top of the minaret and to call the azan. From a plain area also, we can give azan through loudspeaker. But earlier, these minarets were built for two things. One, for giving azan, and another reason is to give an indication that here there is a mosque. So from a far flung area, if anybody sees these long towers, minarets, they will simply understand, yes, there is a mosque there, we can go there to perform our salat. These tall towers are known as what? Minarets. So I told you already, in some mosques presently also, where these loudspeakers are not there, and sometimes when electricity is not there, most of the mosques presently we may find they have generators. If electricity is not there, they can use generator or they can use inverter for calling azan, but earlier it was not there. And some mosques are presently also, they do not have what? Generator is also not there, inverters are also not there, so they are to call azan from these tall minarets. As we have come to know that mosques, that is masjids, are very important for us, they are the sacred, they are the most sacred place for Muslims. So it is our first and foremost duty to keep our mosques clean. It is the house of Allah. We know that it is the house of Allah, where from where we can talk to Allah. So it is our duty to keep it clean. So the question may come to your mind that it is Allah's house, Allah should keep it clean. No, it is not like this. Allah has given this responsibility to keep this clean. We are to clean the mosque every time. Whenever we perform namaz, we are to perform in a clean mosque. No one may enter a mosque in shoes. So to keep it clean, we are to maintain some rules and regulations. Simply, it is known to us, if our rooms are clean, our mothers, that means moms, they do not allow us to enter into the room with chappals, with our slippers, with shoes. So similarly in mosque, it is not allowed to go inside the mosque with shoes, with chappals, with slippers. We cannot go, because if we enter into the mosque with shoes or chappals or with slippers, then mosque may become dirty, and dirt is, that means, not liked by Allah. Our Prophet Muhammad also said that these dirty things are not liked by him and Allah also. So we have to keep this in our mind that we always should keep our mosques very neat and clean, because this is the place from where we can talk to Allah. It should be neat and clean. Without that, we cannot talk to Allah. We cannot perform our namaz. Every mosque has a big prayer hall. Every prayer hall has a niche. Every mosque, we find what? There is a big prayer hall. Mosque means what? A building. Okay? Where people go for namaz. Where people go for some other reason also. Earlier in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's times, you know, people used to sit in the mosque to finish their these problems. They used to ask Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this happened, that happened. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to solve all the complaints, all the problems sitting in the mosque. So presently also, if it is needed, we can go to mosque, and sitting in the mosque we can solve our problems in Islamic way. So whole part of the mosque, we know mosque two parts generally we can find that in our mosques. One is inside part, another one is what? Baranda. So every mosque has one baranda and one big prayer hall. And every prayer hall has a niche. Niche means what? A position, a special position, a perfect position. This is called the mihrab. This niche, this perfect position, this particular special position, name of this is what? Niche. You go to mosque, we go to mosque, we find that one particular portion is there in front of whom the imam stands. In front of that place, the imam stands and he performs namaz. This part, this portion is known as what? Mihrab. This is the particular place why this is built. Normally without niche also we can make built in our home. When we perform namaz, we do not find this niche, or we do not find this kind of mihrabs in our homes. So this is made in mosque. Why? To show the direction towards Kaaba. From India, from our country, from our place, the direction of Kaaba is towards west. That's why this mihrab has been made in the west part of the mosque, and it will be in the middle. That means from mihrab, right side, if the size is what, 10 meter, the left side also the side should be 10 meters. In the middle of the west side wall, we will make a special position. The name of the position is what? Mihrab. Mihrab is for what? It is a special position where in front of which the imam will stand and he will perform namaz, with whom we others, musallis, whoever will go to the jamaat, they will perform their namaz after imam. And this mihrab is made, why? To indicate that this side, the Kaaba, is. We perform namaz towards west. Why? Because Kaaba is in the west side of our country, of our area, of our locality. Kaaba is the oldest house of prayer in Mecca. Kaaba, this is the original house of Allah. It is in Mecca. It is the oldest prayer hall in Mecca. It was built by Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam first. Ibrahim, have you heard his name? We'll get it later on. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he built this Kaaba first, and it is the oldest prayer hall in Mecca. So many prayer halls, masjids are there in whole world, and oldest one is what? The Kaaba. Prophet's mosque, that is Masjid al-Nabawi, it is built so many years after the building of the Kaaba. So we can understand this in Mecca, the name of the house, name of the house of Allah is what? Kaaba, and it was the oldest prayer hall in whole world, not only in Mecca. It is the most sacred place for prayer. This Kaaba is the most sacred place for prayer. People go for Hajj. We know that every year people go for Hajj. Some of your parents have already visited Mecca and Medina for Hajj. Every year people go for Hajj. Why? To visit this Kaaba and to do tawaf around Kaaba. Okay? To move around the Kaaba. Because why? Because this is the most sacred place for Muslims. Muslims do not worship the Kaaba, they worship Allah alone. So here a question may come, that means we are facing Kaaba and performing our namaz. We may think that means we are worshipping whom? We are worshipping Kaaba. Actually not. We are worshipping Allah. We are worshipping whom? Allah. Allah is alone, and we are to worship Him alone. We cannot worship Kaaba. Kaaba, why? Because Kaaba is the house of Allah, and it is in the west side of our country. That's why we are facing towards west. From other countries from where Kaaba is towards south, they will face towards south. In some other countries are there in the world from where Kaaba is towards north, so they will face towards north while performing namaz. So here one thing should be clear, that we are worshipping whom? Allah. And we are not worshipping Kaaba. We are facing towards Kaaba because this is the most sacred place for us, and we consider that this is the house of Allah. We say that Kaaba is the house of Allah. It should be very clear to all of us that we are not worshipping Kaaba. We are worshipping what? We are worshipping Allah. He is the only one who has created everything in the world, and we are worshipping Him only. We are not worshipping Kaaba. We are facing towards Kaaba, thinking that Kaaba is the house of Allah, and we are worshipping not the Kaaba, we are worshipping Allah, the Almighty, Allah subhanahu ta'ala. Because it is holy, all the Muslims turn towards the Kaaba when they offer salah. I said, it is the holiest place for Muslims. That's why we, all the Muslims, when we perform our salah, when we perform our namaz, we turn towards that. The direction of the Kaaba in Makkah is clearly shown in every mosque by the mihrab. That also I said. The direction of Kaaba from India, from our locality, from our village, from our mosque, Kaaba is towards west side. So we are performing our salah towards west side. Okay? So this direction from a mosque we make through or make by what? Mihrab. By mihrab we saw that this is the direction of Kaaba. So mihrab is also a very important place in mosque because this shows us the direction of Kaaba. So everywhere in the world the Kaaba is not towards west. From our country, from our neighboring country Bangladesh also, from Pakistan also, it is towards west, so we perform towards west. From some other parts, if Kaaba is towards south, then they will perform salah facing towards south. Some other countries will be there from where the Kaaba is towards east, so they will perform their salah facing towards east. Even from Medina, when they perform, they do not perform towards east. They do not perform their namaz towards east. They only perform their salah towards Kaaba. So we should not think that we are performing our salat facing towards west. We should think that in our mind we are performing our salat, we are performing our namaz facing towards Kaaba, the house of Allah. And one more thing that I said earlier, once again I am reminding you, we are not worshipping the Kaaba, we are worshipping Allah. And Kaaba is Allah's house, it is commonly known as Allah's house, and it is the most sacred place for all the Muslims in the world. This is all about this chapter. My dear students, I hope you have understood. If you have not understood anything, you go through the chapter again, then it will be clear to you because it is very simple. Then also, if it is not clear, then you can write in the comment box and I am here to reply you. Thank you.